striped pajamas, which was incredible. Very, very amazing and much more wholesome and funny than I thought it would be. It was so incredible. I've read John Grisham, The Litigators, which was really good, actually. Quite different John Grisham. I've started Victoria Hislop book. And I'm having a moment remembering what it's called. But if you just watch, is it called The Return? Just watch part one and you'll see. So actually, super happy with all the books I've read so far, but I would say my favourite was The Boy in the Striped Pajamas. So definitely go read that if you haven't already. Okay, let's get into what's up next then. So, I'm going to start meant to be fascinating, this atlas. Shall I read a bit of the blurb to you? The Sackler name adorns the walls of the British Museum, the National Gallery, the Metropolitan Museum of Art, the Louvre, Harvard, and Oxford Universities. One of the richest families in the world, known for their generous philanthropy, the Sacklers have long been guarded about the sources of their fortune. In reality, they've also been responsible for making and marketing the blockbuster painkiller that became the catalyst for the opioid crisis, in which more Americans have died than in all the wars since World War II. Empire of Pain begins in New York with the story of three immigrant brothers, Raymond, Mortimer, and Arthur, who weathered both anti-Semitism and the poverty that accompanied the Great Depression to qualify as physicians in New York and Glasgow. So yeah, it's just about the Sackler's life. Tragedy and tear-inducing joyfulness of modern India. So, Should we see what it's